Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. We're still exploring the idea of no alcohol cocktails. I'm determined that I'm going to figure this out and I'm going to make something that's amazing. So today we're going to try and make a take on a CosNOpolitan using Seedlip Grove 42. And so the same amount in each glass. Next in is some cranberry juice. And I've got two mixing glasses out here. I'm making two cocktails. I'm going to change one of them slightly. I'm going to add an extra ingredient to one of them. One of the problems I find is that these lack mouthfeel. So in one of the glasses, I'm going to put a little bit of glycerin. And that little bit of glycerin sort of holds the flavor on your palate a little bit longer. Makes the whole thing feel better in your mouth. That was lime juice, by the way. Next in is simple syrup. And then in this one, I'm just gonna put a little bit of food grade glycerin. That much. And I'll ice and shake these one at a time. And they get an orange peel garnish, so little piece of peel.
Hey, Glenn.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. That's very pretty.
It is very pretty.
It looks very festive and fun.
So, drop that in. Often I find when that it can be just a little overpowering when you put out the orange peel in at the same time. So, non-alcoholic CosNOpolitan type thing.
CosNOPolitan?
Yeah. So it's
the puns. They never end.
Yeah, a never-ending pun.
They never end in the...
Exactly the same, except this one has some glycerin.
Okay.
Give it a go.
It was very citrusy.
Mm-hmm.
It's interesting. It's got a bit of an earthy flavor to it, an mm-hmm. undertone to it, which is quite interesting. And yeah, it changes it just
a little bit, doesn't it?
It's very subtle though. Yeah. Like if you weren't doing this like
side by side, I just did a free pour. Maybe a little bit more of the glycerin would improve the impact.
Well, you know, I need to find that out. Mm. Very unprofessionally, add a little more. Here, I got the spoon. Is this the very unprofessional do not do this at home move?
Yes.
I feel like we have done this before sometime. Okay.
Give it a go, Jules.
All right. Well, I was going to try the original first.
Okay.
That definitely lasted, like I'm still, yeah, it's hard to tell because I have that in my mouth.
Yeah. The glycerin doesn't, I don't want to say the glycerin improves the flavor. Because if you don't like the flavor to begin with, the glycerin is just going to hold the flavor.
Just makes it more awful. We learned that lesson.
Yeah, it just holds it in your mouth longer and then you can't get rid of it. But if it's a flavor you enjoy, it allows you to enjoy it a little bit longer.
It's interesting because I was concerned with glycerin because it's a very thick liquid that it would become, you know what I mean? It would be like, and now there's paste in my juice, in my beverage. And it doesn't have that feeling.
It doesn't have that effect.
You don't even notice it, really. Other than that long lasting flavor.
That long finish. Mm-hmm. Now you can, so glycerin, I'm suggesting glycerin, but at the same time, if you made simple syrup as gum syrup, and we've got a recipe for gum syrup, and that is just a basic simple syrup, 1-to-1 sugar and water, but you add gum arabic to it. The gum arabic will do the same sort of thing. It will hold the finish longer. And so you don't have to have an extra ingredient. It's just part of it. Overall, though, I would say for me, this is maybe a little too sweet. I would cut back the sugar a little bit, but there wasn't that much.
No,
it was only a half ounce of simple syrup.
Whereas I find it a little tart with the lime.
Okay.
So
we all taste something different. Worth exploring?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like there's something in there.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
And it's something a little bit more for a guest that doesn't just want to have a Diet Coke at the party. They've got something that looks nice in the glass and they can walk around with. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.